Hello everybody, my name is Tejas. I'm the head chef at Amaranta. Today we are going to make a very simple dish called as kum saag with sprouted black gram or kala chana. This again goes with the philosophy of my restaurant. We do Indian food with a twist, and the twist to this is it's presented in a very different way. So here we are doing creamy spinach, which is nothing but saag. We are doing confit of king mushrooms. अब ये जो मशरूम्स हैं ये स्पेशली अमेरांटा के लिए उगाए जाते हैं. दीज आर वेरी एक्सपेंसिव मशरूम्स एंड दे हैव टू बी ट्रीटेड राइट. दीज मशरूम्स आर बेटर देन मीट. एंड देन वी आर डूइंग अ सैलड ऑफ ब्लैक ग्राम, सो दैट इज़ द हेल्दी एंगल. एंड द स्पिनच इज क्रीमी, द मशरूम्स आर मीटी, एंड द क्रंच कम्स फ्रॉम द ब्लैक ग्राम सैलड. सो कम ऑन, लेट्स गो टू द किचन एंड सी हाउ दिस डिश इज बीइंग प्रिपेयर्ड. तो आज हम बना रहे हैं कुम साग, लेकिन हम इसको प्रेजेंट एक अलग तरीके से करेंगे. खुम अलग होगा, साग अलग होगा, और उसके बाद हम मसाला स्प्राउट का एक सैलड देंगे. तो चलिए बनाते हैं पहले खुम. वी आर गोइंग टू कॉन्फी द मशरूम्स. दीज आर लवली किंग मशरूम्स, वेरी मीटी एंड वेरी लवली टू ईट एंड टू टेस्ट. तो पहले हम ऑलिव ऑयल में इसको कॉन्फी करेंगे. इन दैट वी विल फ्लेवर इट विद सम होल गार्लिक, सम करी लीव्स, सम क्यूमिन एंड सम फेनल सीड्स. A little bit of salt in the oil so that the salt goes inside the mushrooms and some mushrooms. So ye jo tarika hai isko confit kehte hai. Confit means ideally cooking meat in its own fat, but yahan par humne mushrooms liye which are very close to meat, and that's the reason we are using this technique of confiting the mushrooms. Now this kind of cooking is slow cooking. It takes ideally around 40 minutes to an hour's time on a very slow heat. So what we'll do is we'll keep this aside on another induction flame so that it can cook and we can make the sauce for this dish, right? So now while the mushrooms are cooked, getting cooked on the other side, let's make the sprout salad first. Black gram, which is sprouted for 3 days, put in a bowl here. So we'll add in some salt. Pinch of red chili powder, chopped coriander leaves, a sprinkle of chaat masala, and some lemon, of course. You mix it up well, and then you can keep this inside the fridge. You can reserve it in there. This goes aside. Now to make the sauce, take another pan. So I'll add some oil to it to heat. That would be refined oil. This is how ideally a saag would be made in every Indian household. You know, using very very less ingredients, wherein you get the flavor of garlic and some cumin in it. Add some cumin, let it crackle. You can see the cumin crackling in there. Then we add some chopped green chili, give it some spice. Then we add some garlic. We mix it up well. Add in some onions. So you have to make sure that the onions sweat a little bit and they start to turn a little bit golden. And that is when you add in the shredded spinach. We add some salt. That's the right color for the onions. They're turning light golden. That's when you add in the shredded spinach. Okay, it is important to cook all green vegetables or all green leafy vegetables on an open pan. You should never cover them. The spinach is cooked now. You add in the pureed spinach. So this spinach is a simple plain puree of spinach which has been boiled in water for like 1 minute, then put in ice cold water and then blended into a puree. Now spinach is a bitter vegetable to taste, so to counter that you add a little bit of sugar to it. That also ensures that the color remains green and the bitterness goes away. So to finish the sauce, now we'll add in a little bit of cream, just a touch, to make it more creamier and more smoother. That's it. And you see how the color is you know, just brighten up because of just a tablespoon of cream. You need not go heavy on cream, just keep it very light, keep it simple and keep it easy. We'll keep this aside and we'll look at the mushrooms now. So, the mushrooms we had added to cook are ready. This is how they look. So, let's warm them up further and then we can do the plating. So, if you look at the mushrooms, they are thick, they are meaty to look at, but they are cooked through and through. They'll have a lot of flavor of fennel, then the garlic. Also, the salt would have gone through and through to the stem of the mushroom. And I'm sure not many people would have seen such a huge size of a mushroom. So let's start to plate the dish now. Spinach, which is right here. Take some sprouts. Maybe take the mushroom. So that's our dish called as khum saag. So if you look at it very closely, it looks like a forest floor. That is where mushrooms are grown idly. A lot of green, a lot of sprouts around, mushrooms sticking out of the, you know, the forest floor. So all this, these three elements actually compose to form this dish called as wilderness. So that's your dish, which is called as wilderness.